Students, today I am going to teach you electric potential and potential difference. Electric potential. The work done to move unit positive charge from infinity to a point in an electric field is called the electric potential of that point. Potential difference. The work done to move unit positive charge from one point to another in an electric field is called the potential difference between the points. Now the formula for the potential difference. Work done divided by charge. Potential difference is represented by V. Work done is represented by W. Charge is represented by Q. This is a formula for potential and potential difference. The SI unit for potential difference is volt. Putting the SI unit, we get SI unit for potential difference is volt. SI unit for work done is joule. And SI unit for charge is coulomb. It can be written joule per coulomb. If one is written along with both sides, we get 1 volt is equal to 1 joule per coulomb. From here we can get the definition of 1 volt. Okay, students. Now I am going to define 1 volt. 1 volt is the potential difference between 2 points. In a circuit, if 1 joule of work is done to move 1 coulomb of charge, from 1 point to another, 1 volt is the potential difference between 2 points in a circuit if 1 joule of work is done to move 1 coulomb of charge from 1 point to another. I have already taught you resistance. Now we will know about the factors on which the resistance of a conductor depends. Resistance of a conductor depends on length of the conductor. First, length of the conductor. Second, cross section area of the conductor. Third, nature of the material of the conductor. And fourth, temperature of the conductor. There are 4 factors over which the resistance of a conductor depends. Resistance of a conductor depends upon length of the conductor, cross section area of the conductor, nature of the material of the conductor, and temperature of the conductor. The 2 points, length of the conductor, cross section area of the conductor, will be taught by me here in electricity chapter for class 10th syllabus. Two remaining points, nature of the material of the conductor and temperature of the conductor, will be taught you in the higher classes by your teacher. Resistance of the conductor is directly proportional to the length of the conductor. It means if the length of the wire, that is conductor, is increased, then the resistance will also increase. If the length of the conductor is reduced, then the resistance will also reduce. It means the resistance of the conductor is directly proportional to the length of the conductor. That is, resistance is directly proportional to the length of the conductor. And resistance is inversely proportional to the cross-section area of the conductor. It means if we take a thicker wire, it will provide less resistance and the electric current will flow very easily in comparison with a thin wire in thicker wire. It means resistance of a conductor is inversely proportional to the cross-section area of the conductor, that is wire. There are two things. Resistance of a conductor is directly proportional to the length of the conductor. Resistance of the conductor is inversely proportional to the cross-section area of the conductor. Combining this both relation, we get resistance of the conductor is proportional to L by A. Here, it is a proportional sign. We will remove this proportional sign by an equal to sign, and because we are removing this proportional sign, we will multiply the right hand side things by a constant here. R, resistance of a conductor, R is equal to rho L by A. Here rho is the resistivity of the material of the conductor. It is also called constant of proportionality. Here rho, rho, here rho is a proportionality constant known as resistivity of the material of the conductor. Now we can get the SI unit of resistivity of the conductor by putting the value of physical quantities given in this equation. Come on to the point, we are putting the SI units of different physical quantities . It is resistance, its SI unit is ohm. We are going to find the SI unit of resistivity of the material of the conductor. So, I will just write the sign of the resistivity of the material of the conductor. It is length, the SI unit of length is meter, and it is area, the SI unit of area is meter square. Square will cancel the meter. Now SI unit of rho, resistivity of the conductor will be equal to ohm meter. Ohm meter is the SI unit of resistivity of the conductor. Here another point comes in front of us to understand that what is the definition of the resistivity of the conductor. The answer is, resistivity of the conductor is the property of the material of the conductor to resist the flow of charges through a conductor. Resistivity resistivity is the property of the material of the conductor. Material of the conductor. To resist the flow of charges through. The resistance is the property of the material of the conductor to resist the flow of charges through it. Dear students, the next topic will be taught to you is the resistance of a system of resistors, and it will be taught in the next class by me. Thank you. Continue watching videos and take lessons from there. Thank you. A lot of thanks.